I'm John Daniel and you're watching Street Vibes. Today our people speak to an open mic.
It's me that first man, me and Beige, that was first man to sell
so
ice.
So what's your name? What name are you?
My name is Gilbert.
Mr. Gilbert.
They're calling me a snow cone. They just call me a snow cone because I used to sell snow cone, all them things.
And how long you not selling ice cream business there?
It's about more than 50 years.
Yeah, that's a long
more
time.
More than that.
Wow.
Because I see people was small and I sell ice cream for them, and right now they're just more than like me.
So is that you have a joy selling ice cream and making
children
happy?
Yes, I like it.
All right.
I like it.
All right.
Mm.
Respect.
When I sell in, I like to sell. When my mind tell me don't sell, I stay in, I ain't selling. Man, when my mind tell me to sell, I like to sell ice cream.
Okay, I'm one of the players for Lancers Veterans football team. So far, we've been touring around the island doing practice games. We've been winning most of our games. We have a good form. We haven't lost one, actually.
That's about eight games or nine games?
Yeah, eight to nine games. We just played against Lackery there. We won them 5-1. So, yeah. So most of the games lately, last competition, we haven't been scoring goals, but now we've been scoring goals, which is good for us. So we're hoping that we're gonna perform good in the upcoming tournament, and just look out for us, because trust me, we have our kit coming on from England. We have some brand new uniform. We have some brand new players. So we have some young talent. Just look out for us. We'll be doing good.
So Lancers on the roll.
Yeah, we're on the roll.
Yeah. Well, you know, we're taking our little warm-up games because the veteran didn't come in next Monday, you know, trying to get the accuracy, scoring goals. You know, we have our friendlies going on. Look, we just give Lackley a little 6-2 all themselves there. I have three of that. You check it?
So your form, you happy with your form?
It's still not good. You check what I showed you, because we're not holding it the way we're supposed to. Understand? We just have to play a little together, more togetherness and less noise. You check it?
So we say we. What club you play for?
Well, Lancers, the best, you know, all the time. All the time. Lancers, who to look for?
Today is Mr. Sugar's birthday.
To me, that's King Sugar.
Mr. King Sugar's birthday today. He's 87 years old today, and wow. I'm feeling so proud of my husband. This is a husband. For 30 long years, we are together. 30 years marriage. And I tell you, that's a husband. I don't think I'll get a husband like Mr. Sugar.
Once a lifetime.
Yes, have kids, grand, first generation, Mr. Sugar have. And today, Mr. Sugar was very sick. I had confidence that he will see his 87 today.
Mm-hmm.
But he didn't have any confidence. I tell him, Sugar, you will be seeing your 87. And thank you, the Almighty, for my husband seeing 87 years old today. And Father, thank you. I have to give you thanks and praise. And all those who was praying for my husband in his sickness, thank you so very much. Especially the staff at DBS. The love they have for Mr. Sugar. The love they have for me. Asking the Lord to bless them. And people, I'm telling you, when you're 87, it's not an easy road, you know. None of the young children that are raising now will not see an 87. Not even me, I think I will see 87. I'll be 60 next year. But 87 is not a game, you know. It is a strong game. And that man worked all his life in London. All his life in London. For how many years in London? He went there in the 60s and back to St. Lucia because he get a sweet, loving, shabbing Frances Rob. And he cannot move out from that shabbing. And he stick there and he love me and I love him too.
Yes, so my son is part of the football team with Coach Trevor. And it was awesome watching them play today. It's a great way to keep them active. He has a lot of energy. Keep them occupied and, you know, engage in sports. And it was good to see him play. He scored a goal, so it was a wonderful experience.
Yeah, Darren Fisal, technical director for football in the North. Well, I personally, on a football level, I believe the football on a youth level is on a rise in the island. And I must say kudos to the Football Association, because during these holidays there, we had quite a few activities on this respective field. And I have to give kudos to the coaches who had the kids coming out. We recently had a program with Phil Bologshaw and Stuart Charles, accompanied by two national players, Zane Pierre and Saint-Prix. And honestly, you could see the children passionate about the game of football, and it tells you a lot, you know. Give thanks to Kickstart which has an avenue for those kids to get out there, to, you know, go to colleges, help, you know, with their education so that they could come back and give back. So kudos, football is going the right way. So give thanks and praise for the association and the coaches and the kids who are trying their utmost best to rise to football in the island.
Chill vibes out in Penrith today, making it a pleasant and blessed day. Everybody here, very nice, very beautiful out there. Fuel Heritage Day, we on the road to Hotel Chocolat. We have the whole embrace of Helen's daughter on board, the beautiful, inspiring young ladies.
Respect.
So, on that note, we pull out.
Respect.
All right? Street Vibe.
Yeah, man, bless up, man. This is your favorite gospel artist, Dwayne Brown. And I want to say, big up Street Vibe going around St. Lucia and highlight all the communities. I love that. Keep up the good work, my brother. God bless you. St. Lucia, number one. Bless up.
Respect.
The gospel artist, Dwayne Brown. Bless up.
It was brought to my attention that in the school system there's a foot and mouth disease and a vomiting and diarrhea that's going on. And usually the Ministry of Health would alert the schools and some and things like that, you know? But apparently the focus is now, I think, COVID and monkeypox and all of that. So they're not checking in it. But a lot of children and a lot of people are having the diarrhea and the vomiting and the foot and mouth disease. So I'm just getting the public to be alert. The Ministry of Health is not alerting them. I'm getting them to be alert that, you know, these are the things are boring. And imagine at the time the person was telling me that a couple of parents passed me and they just came from the health centers and they were saying that their child had these things, you know? So people, be careful. Wash your hands. Try not to hug too much or squeeze. If you see people have things around their mouth, when you see people vomiting, make sure you protect yourself when you're cleaning them. Right.
Here, what the Street Vibes with me, John Daniel. So proud to see a man live to be 87 years. That's a privilege, and we toast, and with that toast, happy with the sugar, we bring you back to our studio.